What is bagging technique? How is it useful in a plant breeding program? Okay, students. Now, we'll be studying about the bagging technique and what are its advantages or useful in a plant breeding program. Now, generally, this bagging technique is used in artificial hybridization. So, artificial hybridization is a process which is done by humans. And during this process, bagging technique will be used. Now, as we all know, in plants, the gametes are non-motile. And for this gametes to reach, for fertilization to occur, there are different kinds of pollinating agents. Now, these pollinating agents can be wind, water, it can be birds, animals, etc. Now, due to various pollinating agents, during hybridization method, there are more chances for the pollens to transfer and get pollinated. And if this occurs, we will not get a desired hybrid. A hybrid plant, what we have selected or what a farmer have selected or a person who is performing this technique, the desired hybrid will not be obtained. In order to get rid of pollination from an unwanted pollen grains, the bagging technique would be followed or it would be used. Now, the removal of anthers from the female flower when the flower is in the bud condition, so that is before the anther dehiscence, that is the anthers break open and the pollen grains are released, and this is done by using a pair of forceps, and this method is called as emasculation. So here we can see, now this is a flower in the early stage, it has not yet bloomed, it is in the bud condition. Now inside this bud, the andrisium and gynoecium is present. They are immature in nature. It is not completely developed. And due at this particular stage, using these forceps, the bud is cut open and the anthers are removed. Now from bisexual flowers, now this flower will have either, will be having only the gynoecium. The anthers are removed. So that means the male gametes would be removed from the flower. Now once it is emasculated, the bud would be, now this bud would be covered by a butter paper or a polythene bag. Now bagging refers to the covering of the emasculated flower by using a butter paper or a polythene cover. Now this is covered until the flower matures and the stigma completely grow. So before anthesis, and this is done before anthesis to prevent the contamination of the stigma with the unwanted pollens. So there are two purposes over here. If the flower is a bisexual flower, self-pollination is prevented because the anthers are removed, and cross-pollination will be prevented from a different flower because the bud is covered by a polythene bag or a butter paper. So the pollen grains from a different flower cannot enter here. So cross-pollination is also prevented and self-pollination is also prevented. Now when the stigma of the emasculated flower matures, that is it completely grew, the bags, the polythene bag or the buttercup is removed and this stigma is dusted with the pollen grains of the desired flower. The pollen grains of a desired flower would be dusted on it, and as soon as it is dusted, now this bud would be again rebagged. Rebagged means it is again covered with the polythene bag or the butter paper. Now this flower is allowed to grow for the further changes. Now since the pollen grains have been dusted, now artificially pollination has been done, fertilization takes place, then the seed or the fruit would be formed. So now this flower would be covered until the fruit develops. After the fruit is developed, the bag would be removed. And now this seed has the desired hybrid and it has all the characteristics from the plant what has been selected to perform this hybridization technique. Now, it is a part of an artificial hybridization techniques, and this is used by the plant breeders, and often they use this technique to prevent the contamination of stigma of a flower from unwanted pollen grains. So now here we have learned what is bagging technique and where exactly it is used. So whenever we want to produce a hybrid plant, the pollen grains of a desired plant would be collected. The flower with the stigma is first emulsicated, the anthers are removed, it is covered with the bag until it grows, it matures. Once it is matured, the bags are removed and the pollens are dusted on it and then again re-bagged once again until the fruit is developed. And this technique was also used by Mendel to perform the hybridization experiment, where by using this technique he learnt how the genes are transferred from parents to offspring.